As we're not talking about real estate and we're not talking about drugs. Hey guys, welcome to my channel. It's Asha Mack. Today we're going to be talking about this $600 stimulus check we'll be getting soon and how you should invest it if you're ready. Stick around. All right, so we are getting this new stimulus. The new stimulus bill has been passed, and instead of it being $2,000, it's $600. It ain't much, but it's something. Honestly, I feel like it's a joke. So we're gonna receive it, and hopefully in the most gracious way we can. I wanna reiterate, as I did in the video before, and if you have not seen the previous video to this little mini series, I did a video on how to spend your stimulus check that kind of spoke to all of us that maybe don't have our finances in order at the moment. This particular video is for all of us that are ready to just invest our money. So if you want to check out the other video, I'll link it in the cards. And if not, here we go. So like I said before, always remember to have your essentials in place. Make sure that you are taken care of, that your lights are on, there's gas in the car, you are fed, and all of those things. So yeah, let's get into it. The first really kind of creative way that I feel like is a good way to get started growing your $600 seed money, is that's what we're gonna call it. We're gonna call it $600 seed money, is to flip it. And I think I have mentioned this in some other videos, that flipping your money is a very good short-term gain. So things like, you know, you hear people talk about flipping houses. We're not talking about real estate and we're not talking about drugs. We are talking about things like cell phones, laptops, purses, shoes. Now, if you're a person that can source out some like beat up Coach flats, some gently loved Jordans, some Louis Vuitton luggage, and you're able to restore them, it's amazing. I have literally sat there and watched somebody restore a Coach bag, and I would not have ever guessed that this thing was rescued from a dumpster and looked like it did when they were done. So if you're capable of doing some stuff like that, flip the money, because you know that there is a guarantee that that money will grow. So if you spend $50 on a pair of some type of tennis shoe, and you know that you can resell that once you restore it, for, you know, $85 to $120, man, come on, like do that a few times, then you'll really have some good seed money. So flipping is, I feel like, a very safe way of reinvesting your $600 stimulus check. The second one, and these are in no particular order, the second one is to invest in your education. Invest in you, because nobody can take away what you've already learned. You can always keep reinvesting that knowledge as you go. So do things like take a course, buy some books, buy an Audible subscription. If you're a busy person, you can listen to the Audible books while you're driving, before you go to bed, while you're making breakfast. You can constantly be learning. Get a recertification. If you're a tech person, if you're interested in IT, get some kind of certification. There are so many certifications out there that will help get your foot in the door or give you enough knowledge that you can start working for yourself, that it would be a huge disservice not to take this $600 and invest it into that. Because you think about some of these things, you spend just a couple hundred dollars to get that certification, and then the week you start, you make that money right back. So you never lost anything. Even if it's just a break even, you didn't lose anything. So try and invest in yourself. Think of what it is that you want to be doing 365 days from when you receive that money and invest in it. Now, if you're not interested in flipping money, if you're not interested in investing in your education, and you already know the things that you need to know, but you have a business or you're starting a business, invest in that business. Y'all, this is the time. We always talk about we don't have the time to do it. We don't have the money to do it. Oh man, if I just had that couple 200 extra, 250 extra dollars, I could do this. Well, now you're gonna have it. Because like I said, $600 ain't enough to pay your rent, but $600 is definitely enough to get some licenses, to register your business, to maybe buy that camera or that t-shirt press. Speaking of t-shirt presses, I don't know if you can see, actually I know you can't see my sweatshirt. This is a really cool sweatshirt. It's like nice long sleeves. Side note, baby, side note. Check out this company. It's called The Flowering Stage. I will link them below. This is not a sponsored video, but this is one of these small businesses that started selling t-shirts and sweatshirts and hoodies. And when I tell you, it's like really good quality. It's nice and soft inside. The color is vibrant and juicy. And I think it's soon becoming my favorite sweatshirt. Moving on. Yeah, so invest in your business. Buy those little things that you've been needing that will help you to generate more income. Now, don't buy some like fancy business cards or something like that, a gold pen. Don't do that. Invest in your business so that you can make more money. And once again, that's basically like flipping it again. I'm sorry, I'm keep telling you, flip it, flip it, flip it. You gotta flip that money and invest it in your business. Now, I'm not some stock market or investing savant, so take what I'm saying with a grain of salt, let it plant a seed, and then go and investigate more on your own. But the first thing that I would try to invest in, if I were a person like you, maybe, that is ready to invest, are index funds. Now, index funds are something that's extremely safe. Basically, what they are a portfolio of stocks or bonds that follows the market like the S&P 500 or Dow Jones. They're made up of all the firms and the products and the companies based within that market. And it's extremely safe because it tracks the flow of the market over a long period of time. This is definitely a long-term gain. Don't think that you're going to invest in this and then, you know, wake up the next day rich and then take the money out and just go, you know, to Saint-Tropez or whatever. Is that a cool place anymore? I mean, I know it's beautiful still, but is it cool? So yeah, and then once you get comfortable with something like that, like I said before about investing in your education, you can then start learning things like learning about the stock market, trading Forex even. You know, I hear a lot of people nowadays are talking about that foreign exchange market, and I feel like a lot of people are jumping in the time when they are not really investing money that they are comfortable losing. And if you are one of these people that want to start trying to invest, there is an app called, I believe it's called Paper Trends or Paper Trades. Paper Trade, I will also link that below in the description. And you can practice there. So if you have some spare time, some of this COVID time on your hands, you want to practice your day trading, that would be awesome. That's another way to invest in your education for free. So like I said, $600 is not a ton of money, but it is something, and hopefully we will exit this pandemic better than we started. I want us all to come out winners. You know, this economy is going to take a dip, and if we got a little bit of extra change when we get to the end and it's low, we can just come on in and infiltrate. Like, share, and subscribe. Until next time, be blessed.